Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install PostgreSQL on Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to demonstrate how you can easily create database, create table, how you can easily write some queries to fetch some data from our database. So I'm going to show you all of that on this video. So this video is going to be a bit long, so I'll be recommending you do watch the video till the end. And if you face any issues in middle or if you have any queries, please put a comment in your comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. And if this video is really helping you, then also please do comment. That really encourages me to make more such videos. And if you like this video, please give it a like and also don't forget to subscribe our channel. So without any delay, let's start our video. Now to install PostgreSQL, you need to first simply go to favorite browser. And in the address bar, you need to just simply search with PostgreSQL download and hit enter. And this will show you this www.postgresql.org as a first search result. So here you need to just simply click on this download PostgreSQL. And it's going to redirect to the official site of PostgreSQL. So here you can see that our latest version of PostgreSQL, that is version 16, is released on 14th of September 2023. So if you are watching this video much later, then also it's totally fine. The instructions that I'm going to show you on this video will be pretty much same. And if there is any major differences, then I'll be, you know, again going to make a video. So don't worry. Okay, so for now, what you need to do is you need to just simply click on this Windows, as I am going to show it for Windows. So if you are using some other operating system like Linux, Mac OS, then you need to proceed with all these links. For Windows, I am going to click on this Windows, and this link I am going to put right in our description, so you can use that link as well to land over this site. All right, so once you are here, you can see that we have all these different versions available to download. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to download the latest one. So for that, you need to click on this download the installer. And when you click on that, it's going to redirect to the official site of download of PostgreSQL. So here we have the latest version 16 available. So again, these are all different operating system. For Windows, I'm going to select this one and it's going to start downloading our PostgreSQL in a few seconds. So here you can see that our download has rightly begun. Now I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel it. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that same file is already been downloaded over here, and the file size is 391 MB. All right. So now to install, just simply double click on the installer, and it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes. And let's minimize our download directory, and you can see that our PostgreSQL setup is rightly open. So this is our installation wizard. You need to just simply click on next over here, and it's going to show you this installation directory. So on our C program files, they're going to create this PostgreSQL folder, and they're going to, you know, give that version, latest version 16 folder, and inside that they're going to install all our files. So if you want to change, you can click on this browse button and you can change this location, but I'm going to keep this default and I'll just simply click on next. So here you can see that these are all components that they're going to install. So that includes a PostgreSQL server, then pgAdmin 4. So this pgAdmin 4 will give you a, you know, a graphic user interface. So there we can code. So I'm going to show you all of that on this video itself. So, you know, continue watching this video. And they are also going to install this tag builder. So this tag builder will help to install, you know, some other drivers and all those stuff. So I'll just quickly give an overview on that in latter part of the video. And the third thing is this command line tools. All right. So I'll be recommending you to keep everything checked. Do not do anything. Just simply click on next. And this is going to be our data directory. So again, that same location. So after version 16, they're going to create this data directory, and they're going to, you know, put our data there. Okay. So just simply click on next. And this is the important part. You need to give a password. So you need to, you know, remember this password, whatever you are typing. So you need to use the same password for logging in into our database. So this is fine. Click on next. And again, this is another important part. So this port number 5432. So this is very useful, you know, while you are going to connect your front-end code with the back-end code. So that time this port number is very important. So you can, you know, keep a note of this port number. Just simply click on next now. And I'm going to use the default local. So this is going to be our new database cluster, which is fine, and click on next. So so these are all that they're going to install. Fine, click on next, and it's ready to be installed. Click on next, and you can see our installation has rightly began. So this installing will take some time, you know, about 3 to 4 minutes, I would say. So after that, I'm going to again come back to this video. Yep. So we'll come back. And now you can clearly see that our PostgreSQL is rightly installed. So this, you know, took some time, about 15 to 20 minutes, I would say. So if you see that it is taking a bit longer time, don't worry, it is actually doing its job. Okay, so fine. So after it gets successfully installed, you'll be able to see the screen. So here they have already selected this stack builder option, which is fine. I'm going to show you a bit about stack builder in the coming part. So for now, just simply click on finish and it will open this stack builder because that option was selected, right? So here you can, you know, select this PostgreSQL version 16 on port 5432, and you can click on next, and here you can see that we have lot many options. So mostly we use stack builder for, you know, installing drivers. So here if we expand this database driver, you can see we have these drivers available, like PSQL ODBC, PSQL ODBC for version 64-bit and all. Okay, so this is a bit, you know, on the higher side. So when you are connecting your front-end code with your back-end, so there you need to establish that database connection. So for that you need drivers. So these are all that sort of drivers. Okay, and database server is already installed. So if you expand this, you can see this server is already installed. So that is also fine if you want to, you know, downgrade it to some older version. So here is the option to downgrade the database server. Okay, so you can do all that in a stack builder. Okay, I'll not go too much deeper into this. So I'll just simply cancel this stack builder for now. So main thing is installing PostgreSQL, so which is done, and it has also installed pgAdmin. So let's go to search icon and just simply type over here pgAdmin. And when you type that, you'll be able to see this pgAdmin 4. So let's click on that. And you can see that our pgAdmin 4 is rightly started launching. And you can see that our pgAdmin 4 is rightly launched over here. So let's maximize it. So this is the interface of our pgAdmin 4. So as I have told you during installation, that pgAdmin 4 will basically give you a, you know, graphic user interface or GUI interface. So this is our interface of pgAdmin 4. You can expand these servers. So when you click on expand, it will ask you that password. So remember that password that we have set during installation. So I'm going to use that same password and I'm going to click on OK. So when you do that, you can see that it is rightly connected now. So here is our PostgreSQL server 16, and here is our database. So let's expand our database. So we have this PostgreSQL database which comes with the installation. Okay, so to create a new database, you need to click on this database, then right click, and you need to, you know, hover over this create, and you'll be able to see this database. So just simply click on that and it will open this create database window. So here you need to give a database name. So I'm going to give the database name as test db. Okay, and all other things are fine. If you want to, you know, set the encoding style or the security, so you can do all of that here. And here will be our script, so which will be, you know, actually running in the backend. So, you know, just simply click on save, and it's going to, you know, create a database. So here you can see we have a test DB now created successfully, right? So here you have lot many options like triggers and all. So triggers are a bit you know, on the higher side. So if you want, you know, videos on, you know, SQL, then please put a comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to make more videos on SQL as well. So there I'm going to, you know, discuss about PL SQL, triggers, functions, stored procedure, and all those things. So if you need, you can comment. All right, so for now what I'm going to show you is this schemas. So if you expand this, you'll be able to see this public, and on that public here you can see we have tables. So, you know, to so if you expand this table, right now you can see we don't have any tables, right? So how to create table? So just simply, you know, right click on tables and hover over create and click on table. So this will, you know, open this create table window. So here let's give the table name as employee, and you know, this table space and all are fine. So just simply switch over this column, and here you can add column. So you need to click on this plus icon, and here you can give your column. So let's give the column as ID, and it will be of integer type. And let's create one more, you know, column. So let's give the column name as full name, and it will be character. All right, so now it is fine. You can set the length to 50 characters. All right, so just simply click on save, and it's going to, you know, create our table. So here you can see under tables we have now a employee table. So if you expand this, you can see that our table is successfully created. And if you expand a column, you can see those two columns that we have created, ID and full name, is successfully created over here. All right, so if you want to, you know, write your own script to create tables, so that you also can do. You can just simply you need to click on this test DB, your database name basically, and then you need to click on this query tool. So when you click on that, it's going to open this, you know, query window over here. So here you can write your own script. All right, and I'll go to this employee, and I'll hover over these scripts to write a insert script. So when you click on that, it's going to, you know, again open a query window, so giving a template of our insert statement. So here, let's give a couple of values. So one will be our ID, and name will be our, you know, Rahul Dravid. So I'm just giving one name. I'll just simply select this, and I'll click on this run button, and it's going to run. This Rahul will be within a single quote, this Rahul Dravid name field. All right, so you can you know, select this again and click on run button, and you can see that our query returns successfully. So it is, you know, successfully inserted on our table. So similar way, let's insert one more value like 2, and give the name as Rohit Sharma, and select this and execute, and you can see it has again successfully executed. So now we hover over employee again, right click, go to script, and this time write a select script. So the again, this will give you a select script query window. So you can see select ID, full name. So fine, just simply execute this from our employee table, and you can see those couple of entries that we have done previously, Rahul Dravid and Rohit Sharma, are rightly inserted on our table employee. Okay, and you can easily retrieve all that. So in this way, you can easily install latest version of PostgreSQL, that is version 16, on Windows operating system, And after that, I have also shown you how to use this, you know, pgAdmin graphic user interface to, you know, insert database, create table, column, how to write queries, how to fetch, and all that. So if you need more tutorials, please put a comment in your comment sections. I'll try my best to make more tutorials. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. That will really help me to make more such videos. And also, I am looking forward to create one vlogging channel. So it will be by the name Geeky Script Vlogs. So do subscribe that channel as well. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.